Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen. Do you have a dirty email list and you're wondering not only how to clean it up, but also how to keep it clean on an ongoing basis? We're going to cover that today with my top three tips. Let's get started. First, we're going to talk about how to clean up an existing list. Let's say that you have your list in a CRM platform like Hi-Level, and you can view all of your contacts on the smart list screen. You can filter out which ones that you don't want to export, and then you can simply click on the export contacts button. So I'm just gonna click a few. I have quite a few in here. I'm just gonna do 20 right now. And then I'm gonna say export contacts. Then I can choose where I want to export my contacts in a CSV file, okay? So we are going to put them in here and we're going to say save. Then what we're gonna do is go into Mailgun and we're gonna log in and click on validations and then validate. Then what you're gonna do, take note of the cost here, okay? You can do a cost estimation based on how big your list is. $10,000, that's kind of crazy. Hopefully you don't have 4 million people on your list. You can click here to view files and go ahead and navigate to that CSV file that you just exported. Then you can click on generate free preview to get a good idea of the cost and what that would look like. It's not liking the template, so you may have to download their CSV template like this and then reformat your list into this CSV format here. Apparently, they just want the emails, so that's why they don't like my list. You can see here from previous lists that I have cleaned, you can view the number of deliverable, the number of do not send, and the number of undeliverable, as well as unknown addresses. So you can do this to do a one-time clean of your list and see how many are no good anymore. Another thing that you can do to make sure on a more proactive basis that your list is staying clean is use the Mailgun email validation feature. You can do this natively inside of Hi-Level by going to your agency view, clicking on settings, going to Mailgun, and then turning on email validation right here for each account that you want to validate. Again, this is going to cost money, so make sure that you understand the cost before doing so. For me, it's worth it for me to have a clean list because that keeps my sender reputation up. So I'm not worried about the pennies that it costs to validate a new email. Again, this is only going to validate the new email addresses that come in, and then it will not validate it again. So let's say that an email was good when it first came in, and then 6 months later, the company went out of business and it no longer exists. Email validation will not work. You're going to have to employ some of the other techniques that I'm showing you here in order to keep your list clean on an ongoing basis, okay? Another thing that I do inside of Hi-Level to make sure that I'm not continuing to email people when the email has bounced back is to create a trigger for when an event bounces to set the contact to do not disturb. So I'm gonna show you guys how to do that now. Let's say that you have a campaign, you are not happy with this bounced number here, and you can see here almost 10% bounce. That is not good for me as the sender, and it's not good for my server. So what you can do to make sure, other than clicking this and having your VA manually remove every single one, which just wasn't going to work for me, you can actually go to triggers, create a new trigger, and you could call it when an email bounces at the contact to D&D. So what we're going to do here, we are going to say when an email event, and again, this only works when you're using Mailgun. I'm going to show you how to do SendinBlue here in a second. So for Mailgun, email event, event, bounced. You can also set them up for unsubscribed or complained, but I'm going to say bounced. Okay. Here we are going to enable contact D&D. And then we're also going to go ahead as a best practice and add a contact tag called bounced. We're going to turn it on and then we're going to save it. And what this is going to do, every time you have an email that bounces, it's going to enable D&D for that contact. Now, I will tell you, small caveat, as of right now, if you do this, if you enable this trigger, it is going to also not text this person any longer. So if you want to keep texting the person, unfortunately, this method is not going to work for you. You're going to have to use the first two methods and just keep cleaning your list on a regular basis. It's a little bit harder to be proactive about it. Now, if you are using SendinBlue, I have a little bit different set of instructions for you on keeping your list clean. So let's go ahead and go through that now. So if you're using SendinBlue, you have to set up a zap with a webhook in order to catch those bounced emails, unsubscribes, etc., and no longer contact that person. So the first thing you're going to do is go into Zapier and create a zap. I have a new zap open here and I'm going to start typing in webhook. Go ahead and click on webhook and then click on catch hook. Copy this link to your clipboard and then go over into SendinBlue and log in. You'll be able to go to transactional and then click on settings. You'll see this menu item called webhook here. And then you're going to click add a new webhook. Go ahead and paste your webhook in. And here you're going to choose soft bounce, hard bounce, invalid email, complaint. You could do unsubscribed or blocked. You can really set up whatever you want here. You can do error. It's up to you how many of these that you want to catch, okay? And go ahead and click on save. Now, what you're going to do is click on test and click on okay. Go back into Zapier, click continue, click on test trigger, and it's going to find your data. This is super important. Click on continue. And what we're going to do here is we're going to add a high level step. And we are going to stop all campaigns for this lead. Now we're doing this because if they're in a campaign that has, let's say, six emails, you don't want to keep sending them all of the emails in those other campaigns because then your sender reputation is going to go in the garbage. So go ahead and click on email. Click on the email address here, click continue. And this is going to stop all the campaigns for this lead inside of Hi-Level. I'm gonna go ahead and skip that test because that doesn't exist. We're gonna create another step here. And we're going to type Hi-Level again. And on this step, we are going to add and update the opportunity because what we're gonna do is add a contact tag here. So we're going to map the email. Then under tags, we're going to say bounced. All right, so bounced. And then we're going to go ahead, test it. It may not work because you may not have a contact with that example email in Hi-Level. And I forgot to mark it as a lead, so I'm not going to mark it as a lead. And then you can just choose like your lead pipeline or whatever. And then we're going to go ahead and click continue. and go ahead and test and review here. Okay, and then the final thing that we need to do, if you did not do the trigger step in high level with the enable D&D, even if you did, what you're going to need to do is kind of switch it up a little bit. So what I'm going to say over here is when the contact tag is added with bounce, then I'm going to enable the D&D like this. So if you're using SendinBlue, this will do it. And again, it's not going to text them any longer, so you will need to keep that in mind. But for me, it's worth it to keep a clean list. So I hope this helps you guys clean up your dirty email list and keep it clean. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me, and I'll see you next time.